a crazy week in Big Ten women's basketball. Upsets. I feel like everyone came to play the last game of the season.
Definitely.
They definitely came to play. And all those plays are going to be in our BTN standouts today. Guys, let's check it out. Coming in at number five, we're going to start it with Michigan State.
Baked it in. I mean, Christmas comes too much too late for Giancosta. She's got 22. Woo!
Tori Giancosta hits the off-balance three-pointer to tie the game, but they just don't get it in the end with that one. Let's go to College Park. Shatori Walker-Kimbrough and Brianna Jones.
Not sure what else Minnesota could have done.
They would have had to play seven players, which you can't do in women's basketball.
Don't you like that? Seven players on the court for them?
At least.
Coming in at number three, Caitlin Flaherty with the Euro step there. A lot of questions. We don't know if that was
Oh, it's good. It's good. Don't go there. It's good.
What a move,
you get
Caitlin,
two steps. You get two steps.
All right, guys. Well, let's take a look at number two, Ohio State at Rutgers. Our Big Ten Player of the Year, Kelsey Mitchell, with the no-look reverse layup. Guys, what can't she do? She's making buckets with her back turn.
With her back turn, eyes closed.
Back turn, eyes closed. She had a game high of 21 points. Northwestern at Purdue coming in at number one. 5 seconds left in the game. Game tied at 59. Ashley Morissetti trying to get the bucket, but then doesn't get it. Adriana Keys, though, she saves the day.
It's just how they drew it up. Like they said, you draw up the air ball shot for the rebound and put back. It was a brilliant move by Sharon Versa.
It's called the alley. Ooh, 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 oops.
I like that, Vera. I think everybody had their fingers crossed on the bench for that one.